गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियोज आई हैव रियली प्रेजेंटेड द फैक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द काउजेज ऑफ फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन बिलोंगिंग टू द सोशल फैक्टर्स एंड द इकोनॉमिक फैक्टर्स प्रेजेंट इन फ्रांस बिफोर द रिवोल्यूशन विच वेयर रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन. नाउ टूडे I'll give you some information regarding the political causes and the role of philosopher perhaps before the revolution. It is very much clear when we study the comprehensive conditions of France as well as Europe in 18th century, then a very contradictory condition of France can be noted. What was the contradiction? The contradiction was that in one hand the France was on the epitome of the highest glory and proud between the other European states and their rulers. The French custom, traditions, family life of royal court and the members of the royal family, as well as the language, all of these were matter of imitation in other parts of Europe, and they felt very much proud to imitate it, to follow it. So in one hand the France was at the top of the order in the ranking of the estate, but on the other side in internal part of France there were many contradictory facts which were really signaling the weakness of the French state. That's why a renowned historian of Europe, Catalby, had betterly described this condition in these words. What René Catalby said? The flower of French monarchy was blooming on the piles of the dung. यानी कि फ्रांस का राजतंत्र गोबर के ढेर के ऊपर खिल रहा है. इट मीन्स ऑन वन साइड वेयर देयर इज द ब्राइट साइड, मेनी एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द फ्रेंच स्टेट वाज क्वाइट ब्राइट. पीपल यूज टू फॉलो इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ यूरोप. On the other side, there was many a weakness present in the French society and the polity, which had really compelled the French people to go for a revolution. What were the conditions which can be mentioned under the heading of the political causes? The first is divine theory of kingship. That means the monarchs, the kings of France believed in this very theory. According to this theory, the king was the representative of God on the earth to rule on the people. And none had the right to defy the order of the king because he was the representative of the God. His will was only become the law. There are no proceedings. So the king was the representative of God on the earth to rule the people, and their will become the law. The king did not want any restraint on his power to rule on the people. But now the conditions of Europe was going for a big change. Now liberal theory, liberal political concepts were going to be popularized, and it has really changed the scene. That's why the changing condition of Europe now, liberal ideology was getting a place in mass, who emphasized on election and representation of public in a state affairs. Yani ki ab janta चाहती थी कि हमारा भी प्रतिनिधित्व रॉयल कोर्ट में हो, और जिसके एडवाइस पर ही राजा डिसीजन ले. किंग मस्ट नॉट एक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज और हर विल. सो दे वांटेड टू हैव एन इलेक्शन सो दैट दे कुड इलेक्ट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स फॉर देमसेल्व्स. सो दिस थ्योरी of kingship, the divine theory, was now a matter of criticism among the public. Dusra, second jo cause hai, wo failure of king. In fact, before and after the accession of the Louis XVI, before, under the reign of Louis XIV, a very prolonged war was fought between England and France. Not in only France, but in many parts of Europe, for gaining more and more colonies far up from France or Europe and prove their superiority on each other. So this rivalry was really proved very much insultative for the France, because on certain occasion, many occasions, England was seemed to going ahead by defeating French army on many occasions in different parts of the world, and it had really lowered the prestige of king before the public. It had maligned the royally the face of the monarchy, the kingship. Again, after the accession of Louis XVI, then he tried his best to introduce reforms so that the condition of France could be improved. But since he lacked the determination and the willpower to improve, he failed and ultimately left with no option to call for a meeting of States General. Now, during the meeting of State General, when the meeting was ongoing, the representative of the third state wanted equality in the royal court. In fact, the representative of the third state were kept standing behind the chairing members of first state and second state in the royal court. It was really very, very much insultative for the members of the third state. That's why they felt very much insulted. Again, these members became angry when the king rejected their demand to vote on the basis of the number of representative in the court. They demanded that what was the traditional pattern in the voting in the state, was that each state really given the power to vote only one. But these members were demanding that it is not acceptable. So each member, each representative should vote one vote on the issue during the voting. The king, since believed in divine theory of kingship rejected their proposal and I reject these members of third estate by quarter deputy. Further, now after the boycott, they gathered in the nearby tennis court and declared themselves the sole representative of the French people, because really they represented the 90% of the people of the France. They also constituted a body who were given the charge to make a constitution for the France, naming National Assembly at that time. Really, these incidents which happened in succession brought the revolution closure. Now, the fourth couch that is very much important is the role of philosophers. These philosophers were really intellectuals of the time, and these intellectuals were very much busy to awake the French people through their books, commentaries, or speeches in public, quite before the revolution. Now, the society was started to raise the questions on prevailing bad conditions of the people in France. The philosophers really not only put their fingers on the ongoing problems of the people, but also give alternative remedies, and it has really made the people very much awakened to take a start. And when that time came, they had taken the action. Among the renowned philosophers of the time, some are mentioned below. The first one is the John Locke. In his book, Two Treaties of Government, he pleaded to refute the public, the divine theory of kingship, which had prevailed in France, and encouraged to challenge the absolute right of the king, which really did not care for the well-being of the masses and only acted for fulfillment of their personal interests on the cost of the life and property of the people. The second one is the Jean-Jacques Rousseau. In his famous book, Social Contract, he declared that now the contract between the people and the rulers had been breached, which was once made, and it was in ancient period, between the rulers and the people to keep a society in order and to bring the peace and prosperity in the society. But the conditions of the contract had been quite earlier breached by the rulers. Now it is the time for the public to come forward and to have a fresh contract between them and their representative, rejecting the authority of the king. और राजा के अस्तित्व को नकारने के बाद की उसने Now they should know the role of the king. Now it is the time when the people itself had to take the command, the charge, and through representative should set an order in the society for the well-being, progress and prosperity of the people. The third one, the renowned philosopher was Montesquieu. In his famous book, The Spirit of Laws, described very much emphatically that concentration of power in one hand or in one group make the ruler or the king or the authority autocrat, a dictator. So what to do in that case? The only way that the power to rule must be distributed among the different wings of the government. And what about the institutions which are under government to carry the responsibility of the government to rule? Those may be the form of legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. Really, such system of distribution of power among the different institutions of the government really keep a check and balance on each other in the government, and none could come there to become a dictator or rule by decree. So these ideas are different philosophers now, fourth point, through ideas of different philosophers became very much popular. Even the peoples of the first state and second state, even if their interests were against these philosophers' ideology, yet they prayed many more on several occasions, even theaters, even on public programs. They used to clap the dialogues in dramas, which were generally given in the play. So, such ideas and ideals of these philosophers became very much popular among the public. Even the adversaries of the common people were very much fascinating about these ideas. They also prayed on several occasions. That's why very much common behavior of mass was coming to existence in France, and that was in form of debate and discussions on public places on different issues, even like in the saloons and the coffee houses. They decide on several occasions and times the different institutions of the government, the different acts of the government, the different policies of the government. So, such tendencies were increased due to increased circulation of newspaper in reading class, and also in those class which we are reader class and who used to read books. Thus, these philosophers really make the intellectual ground for the happening. Quite before 1789, now,
today I finish it, and in further class in future I'll deal the other aspects and even the causes, immediate causes, and afterwards related to the causes of French Revolution. So wait for the next video of mine, and if you find interesting facts in my this video what I present before you for a comprehensive study of the history textbook prescribed by CBSE for the 10th class and 9th class, you can subscribe my video also, share it also with your friends for the propagation. Thank you.